Good morning, friends. I am Babita. Today we will discuss about Alexander Pope, who was a famous writer of Augustan age. Before knowing about Alexander Pope, let us know something about his age. Neoclassical age. Neoclassical age started from 1660 till 1785, and this neoclassical age is divided again in three parts: Age of Restoration, Age of Augustan, and Age of Sensibility. And the Age of Sensibility is again known by a transitional age also. And all these three ages are dominated by one writer. Like the Age of Restoration is dominated by Dryden, Age of Augustan is dominated by Alexander Pope, and Age of Sensibility, that is transitional age, is dominated by Samuel Johnson. But today we will discuss only about Alexander Pope. We will discuss other ages in next video. So, friends, Alexander Pope was born in 1688 and lived till 1744. He was a son of linen draper. I will tell you some special quality of Alexander Pope. Alexander Pope was not a sensible person. Sensible means he never think that the person with whom he is talking may be felt bad by his saying. He told in front of him his fault and his goodness both. So this is a quality you can say, and this is a bad quality also. And this quality is also can be seen in his work also. And his work is divided in two parts: earlier group and later group. In earlier group, there are Essay on Criticism, The Rape of the Lock, translation of Homer. And in later group, The Dunciad, The Satire and Epistle, Essay on Man, The Epistle to Arbuthnot. One by one we will discuss about them. The first one is Essay on Criticism, that is published in 1711, and it has many maxims. First we will see what is Essay on Criticism. It is an essay, it is written in a couplet form, and it is written on the topic of criticism. Criticism means to pick the qualities and the fault of other person. So this is how much important for literature. He want to tell us that criticism is a very main part of literature. So there are so many maxims also in this criticism. You will find like a little learning is dangerous, to error is human, to forgive divine. So such type of good sayings you will find in this work. And in next work, Rape of the Lock, it was published in 1714. It is completed in mock heroic style. And in this work also, Alexander Pope criticized the society, because that time society engaged to decorating himself and showing himself better than the other person. So he wants to show the society that this is not a good quality of a person. So in this work, there is a lady that whose name was Arabella Farmer, and she was decorated by self, norms, and other spirits. And at last, a man cut his lock of his hair. So this is not fair, and the whole work is written only about the cutting of lock. So now we will discuss about the Eloisa to Abelard. In this we will find the theme of love, written by Alexander Pope. In this, Eloisa is the heroine of this work, and she at last think that this love is not good for me. I should devote myself to the service of God. And at the last work of the earlier group is translation of Homer. Homer was a Greek poet. He wrote Iliad and Odyssey, that is a great epic, and Homer tried to and Alexander Pope tried to translate these two works into his own words. After finishing Iliad, he tried to translate Odyssey, but he could not finish. At last, the two writers, Phantom and Brumi, started to complete this Odyssey, And you will find that there is no difference between the work, the style, the words. Also, Phantom and Brumi and Alexander Pope, both the writings are same. Now, letter group, Dunciad is so much famous. It was appeared in 1725 and enlarged in 1742. And this is a violent satire. This is a violent satire against Theobald. Theobald was a poet of that time, and Alexander Pope wrote this Dunciad against Theobald. And in this work, he told that Theobald was the king of dullness. He is not suitable for a great writer. So now we will come to the essay on man. An essay on man is written in 1733 till 34. And in this work, you will find the relation of a man with universe, with himself, with society, and with happiness. And the last work is Epistle to Arbuthnot. Epistle means letter. So this work is written in the letter form. And the other quality of Alexander Pope are mastery of heroic couplet. He wrote all his works in heroic couplet. Heroic couplet means two line saying, within two line he tell a full thought. And epigrammatic expression, it means that he express his views in few words. Within few words, he tell us so many deepest thought. So this is the main quality of Alexander Pope. Heroic couplet was made famous by Alexander Pope basically. Before Alexander Pope, it was used by a Chaucer also, but the maximum work are written by Alexander Pope in heroic couplet form. Friends, I want to tell something about the Dunciad also. In Dunciad, you will find that Alexander Pope wrote a work that's name was Addition to Shakespeare in 1725. When Alexander Pope wrote this work, there was a writer that's name was Theobald. He wrote another work, Shakespeare Restored, against Alexander Pope, against Addition to Shakespeare. And in his work, Shakespeare Restored, Theobald pick out so many fault of Alexander Pope. So taking revenge against Theobald, Alexander Pope started to write Dunciad. So this is the reason why the Alexander Pope started to write and said, I want to tell you. So friends, that's all for today. And in next video, we will discuss about the other two ages, about Dryden and Samuel Johnson. Thank you for watching my video.